dernière fois, ton rire qui résonnait partout, emplit mon cœur de joie. Lorsque je vais
y passer.
Maurice, you're fat.
And you are thinner. Jeannette. Look.
Charles, comment êtes-vous revenu? Vous êtes méchant. Vous n'écrivez pas, vous disparaissez.
English, Mama, English.
She loves you in French. We all miss you in any language.
It does not look well.
That means she wants to feed you. You're away too long. Almost 2 years, huh?
Thanks, Maurice. You remembered.
Bourbon straight, water on the side. It's you and Mr. Gamble. Only people who speak English would put things like that in their stomachs. You're back on business, perhaps?
No, no, just to see my little girl.
Oh, little ballerina. Did you not go back with you?
No more for me, thanks.
The world has changed.
Yes.
It's not so crazy anymore like it was after the war, huh? You remember? We had much laughter together, eh, Charles?
Maybe we had too many laughs, Maurice.
Bourbon, no gin, no cognac, no anything.
How will you celebrate?
For me, I keep the permanent.
For you and me.
That lady over there, how do you say, she gives you the eye.
That one? It's not even smiling at me.
The eye without a smile is the most dangerous eye.
Excuse me.
Charles!
Claude! Oh, I knew you'd make it.
Oh, but you. I was afraid.
Nah, don't you know the bad characters never die in a war? Excuse me, I saw my old friend and I...
This is my dear and crazy friend, Charles Wills. Miss Ellsworth.
Miss Ellsworth.
Marion, please.
American? You've been here all through this?
Oh, we never left. Dad and I stayed on in an occupied French Leon mostly. No, Claude.
Oh, he was an observer with our outfit. I haven't seen him since D-Day in Normandy.
I parted company with the U.S. Army after Saint-Lô.
Back into the FFI?
With the General de Gaulle.
Quite a coincidence meeting here.
Well, if I hadn't seen you in the mirror, I thought some stranger was giving me the eye.
But no, no, I didn't see you.
Am I interrupting anything important?
Well, Mario and I are...
You must have influence around here. You have a drink.
Power of the press, ma'am. Let's see what my influence and lots of money can accomplish. Maurice!
I've got a better idea. Let's go to my father's celebration.
Well, where would he get enough whiskey for a party?
You don't know my father.
To fathers.
To men.
To Frenchmen.
Continuez la célébration. Ne soyez pas danser au chaisée de votre maison. Nous allons essayer de vous le faire voir. Bonsoir.
Harry, my boy, you have a thirsty look in your eye.
Oh, does it show?
Maybe it's going if you have a drink.
André!
And who have we here?
Charles Wills. He's a reporter for the Stars and Stripes. This is my boss.
How do you do, sir?
A reporter? We don't need a reporter. We need a bartender.
I invited you here because it seems to be the only place in town where you can get a drink.
And do you know that all these people came to precisely the same conclusion? Your sister has made me very proud. We couldn't tell you the good news before, but Helen has been expelled from the university.
What? If we're going to have a scene, either ask this young man to leave or introduce him.
Marion, please.
Helen.
Oh, now, look, let her alone. After all, I was expelled from Harvard, wasn't I? Why shouldn't a girl follow in her father's footsteps?
Excuse me a moment.
I'll talk to you later.
I have a feeling she'll be talking to me, too.
Name, please?
Charlie something or other. He says he's a bartender.
Oh, yes.
Charlie what?
Wills. I wish I were a bartender, a nice civilian bartender.
Oui, je vous offre un peu de champagne?
Oh, merci. Voulez-vous me prêter votre
main? Bien sûr.
Cette bière, mes
deux. Si, vous ne restez pas trop long d'accent.
I told him we knew each other.
Well, we do in a way. We were only kissing an hour ago.
We were? Now. You were one of the ones at the Ritz bar. Et toi? Place Vendôme. I know. Near the Dingo Cafe.
You do remember.
No. It's the only other place I ran into more uniforms today. Are you rich?
No. Does that finish me off?
No, but it does slow us up a little. We're not rich either. We just live that way. Daddy says it's the same thing, only it's much cheaper.
I think I like him.
That's good. Because he'll try to borrow money from you, and I don't want him to be disappointed. I like the way you kiss.
Really?
Dear, I'm afraid I've underestimated the alcoholic capacity of our guests.
I'll only be a few minutes.
Oh, get the bartender here to help you. Say, Wills. Wills. Are you one of the wealthy Willses from Maryland?
No. This way, Lieutenant.
Thank you.
Milwaukee.
Would you help me?
Sure. Noted for good beer, women with lovely legs, and practically no millionaires. And you?
New York till I was 12. Then Daddy moved us to Paris. When the Germans came in 1940, I was sent to school in Switzerland. That's where the loot's kept.
No.
Daddy put it there so the Germans wouldn't drink it.
Very resourceful man.
And lots of fun.
Is he?
That's his 11th commandment, having fun. Especially now. He says that after a war, everybody should always be gay and have fun.
Isn't your father a little old for this war?
Oh, he wasn't in this one. He was in the 1918 war, and he's been celebrating ever since. Now that the war in Europe is over, what are you going to do?
Try to stay out of the war in the Pacific.
That's very sensible. That ought to be enough to tame the tiger.
Charles, I was wondering what had happened to you.
Nothing. Yes.
Everybody's waiting to meet you.
Well, I've really got to report back to the paper with some sort of story.
Oh, can't you stay just a few minutes?
I'm sorry, I've got a deadline.
Oh, Lieutenant, don't take the party with you.
That's a nice love. Do you think someday soon we might be rich? Could you come back later?
All right, I'll try.
Better yet, I'll meet you. You call and tell me where.
All right.
Hello? Who is this, please? Who? Oh, Helen. This is Charlie Wills. No, no, Charlie, the bartender.
The army bartender?
That's right. Could you give Marion a message, please? Tell her that the lights of Paris go on tonight for the first time since the war began. Well, she wanted to meet me.
At the Arc de Triomphe, right by the shrine for the unknown soldier.
Thank you.
Et le général de Gaulle va dans cette foule délivrée par les rondeaux de tous à celui qui dort à jamais inconnu, à jamais présent, sous la bouche des victoires.
Promise me something. Promise. Don't ever let the celebration end.
There'll be another celebration when the rest of the war is over.
But it is over. For us, it's over. I'm sick to death of death. I want to enjoy things and have fun. And live like every day is the last day. Wouldn't that be nice? A lifetime full of last days. Except it never really would be a last day. You're too serious. Make that nice, Ma. I don't care if you're not rich. Yes, he did. He's trying to make time with me.
Dad!
What is it, animal or vegetable?
Powdered eggs! Chocolate!
You shall not go unrewarded, my boy. Come to think of it, your generosity shall be repaid this very day. Now,
Good morning.
Look, meat, eggs.
About the powdered eggs, you see, they look something like
Never
eggs.
Never mind, we'll cook them in sherry. That'll make them taste like
it. Helen, please, I wish to make some small token of appreciation. Charles, my boy. A golden opportunity awaits us. Now, the question is, are we equal to the challenge?
Well, what is it, sir?
Benedictine in the fourth race today. He'll go to the post at 10-1. At a mile and 3/8, he can't lose.
Why not?
It's a trade secret.
Daddy means he has a hot tip, right?
Another hot tip?
Look, we have less than 2 hours to become wealthy.
I think I can come along. I'll make a phone call.
Excellent. Now, if we pool our resources, what is your capital, my boy?
About $40.
Let's see. That means if we pool our resources, we have $40.
What a pity.
Maybe I can borrow some.
Don't you do it, Charles. He'll keep you as broke as he is.
Opportunity, my dear, is concerned with the future, not the past. Look. If it's collateral you're worrying about, I happen to own oil leases in Texas that are worth, you know, Texas.
Oh, Daddy. The oil leases are a family joke. Plenty of leases, but not one drop of oil.
Charlie.
What?
I feel lucky today.
I'll see what I can dig up.
I have the utmost confidence in the courage and ingenuity of the United States Army. To horse, my boy, to horse. Destiny hates a laggard.
The paper said the...
Don't be nervous. Daddy's really very brilliant.
Well, what could possibly make me nervous? If we lose the race, I'll owe half a year's pay. The money belongs to four captains who fought their way out of Bastogne with their bare hands.
We won't lose.
Well... Did you bet at all?
Every penny, and at 12 to 1.
Why did the odds go up?
The suckers think that Benedictine will lose. What can you expect of agnostic, my boy? Over this way, what?
Which one is Benedictine?
Number 4. He lay back for the first half mile.
He looks scrawny.
Lean, my boy. Lean and ready and fit.
Who gave you this tip? It's Benedictine.
Running beautifully.
Where is he?
Sixth, in perfect position. He's outsmarting him.
Helen.
I think I'll buy a new dress with my share of the winnings.
Helen.
Why should that surprise you?
Not so much surprise as relief.
You know, at 12 to 1, that makes your share.
Maybe there's another race fixed today.
Fixed? Fixed race, my boy?
You mean this race wasn't fixed?
You've been reading too many crime novels.
There was no hot tip either, was there?
Well...
You just picked a crazy long shot out of a hat.
Intuition and experience, my boy.
But we could have gotten killed.
It's a wonderful way to make a living, isn't it?
This is the American Forces Network in Paris. A pall of black destruction and chaos still hangs over Hiroshima. Events are now moving swiftly. The president of the...
Hey, Marie, do you hear the news?
First things first.
It'll take more than one bomb, Dan, this caper. One will get you 20, it's over in a week.
Will you cover 60 bucks for it?
You got it.
Don't do it. Barney just came from the office. Japan offered to surrender here.
What?
We let the emperor stay in his throne.
When are we going home?
Charlie, what's the dope on discharges?
Well, if you start right now, you're already behind 10,000 other guys.
I have to get right back to the office.
Why?
I tried to phone you.
Don't ever phone if you can possibly come yourself. Don't ever leave if you can stay.
Maybe we can meet for late supper or something.
We'll see. Is it really over, the war? Because I want to buy you silk shoes, silk socks, silk shorts.
Well, I started over here and stopped a second. Must have lost it. You've got a special edition coming out.
You better hurry.
I'll get you a taxi first. Taxi!
Now you stop fussing about me.
Will you wait for me?
I think I'll go home early and give Daddy a shock.
But in this rain.
I may not be able to cook and to sew, but I really can find myself a taxi. It's the first thing I learned at finishing school. Now you go on here.
You're a girl after my own heart.
Make no mistake about it. I'm after it, all right.
Did you get my flowers?
Every day.
All my messages?
Every one.
Can I go in now?
Charles? Stop questions.
The patient improves, but it is required not to really hurt. Oh,
I was going to ask her to dance, but I guess that's out, huh? I was expecting a younger, more attractive nurse.
She's the fourth in 2 weeks. Daddy's a pincher. Guilty look off your face.
I lost your umbrella. I gave you the flu.
Don't be silly. It was raining. I got wet, so I got the flu. And it's not your fault. I was wondering how you'd look out of uniform. Even better.
It's my fault.
I would have caught this anyway. I catch cold even from weather forecast. Thank you for the lovely flowers.
Oh.
What's the matter?
I don't know. You look so pale and sweet and faceless.
Remember, the nurse is right outside that door. Not that I'll call her.
One thing I learned these last weeks. I love you.
You loved me the first day.
I did.
You sure did. We should have told each other then. Look at all the headway we could have made.
For the first time in my life, I wish I had lots of money.
Oh, money.
Daddy says it isn't what you have, it's what you owe.
I don't even owe enough.
And what are your prospects, young man?
Prospects? My old job on the news at 65 a week.
Please. I'm only supposed to think beautiful thoughts. Do part of General Motors need a president or something?
Well, the Paris office of the Europa News Service needs a reporter.
Paris.
It doesn't pay as much as a New York job.
But you don't need money to have fun in Paris.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, I've been working on a book. I should get back to the
States. Why can't you write your book here? Oh, Charlie, darling. Please marry me and let's stay here, please.
Oh, it sounds wonderful. Isn't it a little crazy?
Yes, it is crazy. If you had any sense, you'd walk right out that door and never see me or call me again. Maybe send back my umbrella. Call it quits.
But I haven't any sense. No sense at all.
You have no sense. I have a 1 degree temperature. If I were 98.6, this would never happen.
But I'm rather enjoying playing the anxious father. After all, it's Helen's first marriage, you know.
Only marriage, sir.
Tut, tut. No arrogance, please. Helen tells me that you're a very serious-minded person. You know, both feet on the ground, hard-working, industrious.
Well, I try to be, sir.
I tell you frankly, these are not the qualities I'd hope for in a son-in-law. I'll go even further. They're not the qualities to make Helen happy.
Oh, well, sir, I'm going to work in a Paris news agency. I'll be surrounded by carefree, irresponsible characters. Some of it's bound to rub off on me.
Mm. Well, let us hope so. Tell me, do I strike you as being an unusual father?
You certainly do.
It's a very straightforward answer. Try to overcome this tendency. You understand, of course, that I can't afford to give you a large wedding.
I don't care for one, thanks.
Care for a drink?
Oh, yes, I'd love one, thank you.
That's too bad. You know, I'm getting a little low on this stuff, and I was...
Oh, that's all right.
Here you are.
Oh, thank you.
Do you know what you're getting for a wedding present?
Well, Helen told me what not to expect.
My dear sir, you are getting the old family joke. 4,000 acres of invaluable oil land.
Thank you very much, sir.
Not at all. You know, after all, it's not bad being an oil baron, even if there's no oil. Did you give Helen your permission?
I had to give her my permission.
Huh?
Claude has asked me to be the mother of his children.
Really? That seems a bit irregular, doesn't it?
Dad, Claude has asked her to marry him.
Oh. Well. Then I suppose I must kiss you.
You say best wishes to the bride and congratulations to the groom. Which way is it? I forgot.
You just go ahead and kiss each other. What did you put into that kiss?
Why don't you come here and find out?
Helen getting married, Marion getting married. A father abandoned in middle age. What man could ask for more?
Give me a rewrite of that, will you?
Feeling?
Pretty good.
Good, good. That beard looks good.
Oh, Charlie, if you're getting around to asking for money, not a chance. I haven't got a franc. If I had any, I wouldn't give it to you anyway.
The prices aren't going up here like in the States.
Neither are the white fellas, please. I got a wife and baby waiting in the hospital. I need $500 to get them out of hock.
Why don't you leave them there? It's the healthiest place in town.
You can make jokes. You're not a father.
Oh, I don't know. All the returns aren't in yet.
How about it, Your Highness? Nothing like a hot tub after a long day of hauling, is there? There. Look at those legs. Will you, regular man, give her? Forgive me, Highness. This is not the folly of Fitzgerald. I beg your forgiveness. What can you expect from the common herd, my lady?
Oh, merci, monsieur Azouet. Je vais sécher et habiller bébé maintenant.
Boy!
So,
well,
I have good news.
Fine, fine. Where's Helen?
Charlie?
Oh, how's Marion?
She's fine.
Well, it's fine, fine.
Fatso is right. Look at me. Bulging out of my own clothes.
I happen to be insane about each and every bulge.
Where's Vicky?
Being bathed.
Mm. I just can't help it. You look so pretty, too. Of course, I've been looking at my editor all day.
Oh, did you hit him for the bonus?
Mm-hmm. I got it, too. Only it's not a bonus. It's a loan. And I sent it right off to the hospital. So you can tell your daughter to come out now. She's all paid for.
I'll never, never be a size 10 again.
Vicky will be exactly like you. Then I'll be surrounded by beautiful women.
That compliment and a martini would just about square you for putting me in jail for 9 months.
Martini coming right up.
Appointed to the prosecutor's staff today.
Well, what about your private practice?
But this is more important. There are many collaborators who must be brought to justice.
Sure. And the lawyers who defend them will get rich, and you'll get convictions and be broke.
Ta-da! Gentlemen, the Queen.
Hello, Highness. What happened to her hair? She had some yesterday.
Wishful thinking, that's all.
You know, she's not bad for a first try.
You'd better be beautiful. A genius is terribly rich.
The beauty she got from my daughter, the genius she inherited from me, you better get busy with your contribution, my boy.
The last 9 months I've devoted to you. Now I'm going to have fun. What do you say, sweetheart? Whee!
Hey.
No guts, eh?
I was wondering if you could, thank you. I trust you're keeping a record of these loans, huh? Good night.
sure you won't come along? You hate me for not holding your hand while you have your baby.
If you held my hand, the next thing I'd hold yours, and the next thing I'd kiss you, and the next thing,
I'd like that.
You're a glutton.
It helps me not to go out.
I can finish this thing tonight.
Please, it's not a thing. It's the great American novel. Will you still worship me when you're famous? Even better than the first book. It's beautiful. It's too good for them. Let's send it off tonight.
Wake up. Spit out it for good luck. Girl.
This Christmas night, it is 5 years since the end of World War II. Veterans everywhere pray that peace will come with the new year.
You're not Ben-Hur. You lost the race.
I need consolation. Hiya, Charlie. I lost the race and your wife won't console me.
Hiya, Charlie.
Next time, win the race, huh?
Good night.
Look. I didn't forget.
Good night, everybody.
Hi.
You haven't told her yet, huh?
Why spoil her fun?
Why let her spoil yours?
I'm peculiar, that's why. I used up a year of my life trying to write a book. For some unaccountable reason, I thought somebody would want to publish it.
My boy, you're not in the least peculiar. You're merely naive. Now, I knew a publisher once, and he made it a rule never to read a manuscript. Oh, he'd smell it and weigh it and feel its taste. Could read it? No. Now, if this manuscript smelt and weighed and felt and tasted like garbage, then he published it. Would you like to know the secret of success? Mediocrity, my boy. To be a rich writer, you've got to remember your three R's. Riches, ruffians, rape.
My cereal, 15,000 bucks.
Our
bucks.
Good boy.
Hey, thanks. Farewell, Hacks, forever.
$15,000.
Tax free, too.
He could have at least thrown a party for everybody.
Good speech.
Merci beaucoup. Charlie, run down to the police station, will you?
What?
They're holding some crazy American dame. Seems she held up traffic by taking a dive into a fountain at noon today.
Not much of a story, is it?
No, but you know how Americans in Paris love to read about Americans in Paris.
All right, what's her name?
Helen Wills.
That's my girl.
No use acting as if you didn't know me. I'm your wife. Sickness and health and dry clothes and death.
You know how you are with colds. You better go home and change.
We can't go home because it's a dingo.
Again?
Isn't she better off in a nice, respectable bistro than all alone at home? It's going to get in the papers?
One more crazy American jumping into one more beautiful fountain? That isn't news anymore. Is that why you did it? To get into print?
I guess it was silly and stupid, but it was fun.
Was it?
Well, almost fun. On the verge of being fun.
Only it never is quite, is it?
No. Somehow it never is. I don't know why. Maybe it's something about Paris or me or the times or something. It's as if you've got to hurry up. Hurry before... It's like you're trying to find out something terribly important, Tony.
Only you never do.
Oh, come on now. You always laughed at these things. Took a little time, but you laughed.
It isn't that. Campbell just sold a cereal in the Saturday Evening Post for $15,000.
And you hate him for it? Oh, darling, I think that's wonderfully human of you. Finally.
À Montparnasse, elle vivra éternellement.
She's saying he's talking so fast.
This is Marcel.
How do you do? Who are you?
He says he's going to immortalize.
Je vous en prie, mademoiselle, un tout petit moment, s'il vous plaît.
What are you, running for office or something?
Oh, you know me. Always good for a couple of laughs.
Sweet. Good thing to make people laugh.
Don't I get anything? I paid the fine to get her out of jail.
Voyons, ma chérie, un petit moment, s'il vous plaît. Oui, je vous en prie. Merci.
Thank you.
Anglais, Vicky. English.
Papa, I've been waiting to show you. This morning, my matrice, my tea.
No, Vicky. Not half and half. All English.
Watch, Daddy, watch.
Hold it. I haven't been kissed yet.
Hey, Charlie.
Barney.
You want to see something great? Go on.
Pretty young to be hitting the bottle, isn't she?
It's the floor, darling.
Even Pavlova couldn't dance on a floor like this. You all right?
I'm sorry.
Say something nice.
It's swell, kid. Great. The boss wants me on an interview with the Royal Francais. I can't handle it. Got a heavy date. Cover for me, will you? The woman's name is Lorraine Quall.
Who's Lorraine Quall?
Cafe Society. So long, kid. You got a great act there.
Great. All it needs is a finish.
You've got the right finish, haven't you, sweetheart? Right into my arms.
Mr. Wills.
Mrs. Paul. I am Wills from the Europa News Service.
I hate to be late. I'm sorry. And I need a drink. Leon?
You say, Mrs. Quayle?
Please. You can skip the usual. Paris is beautiful. American women love French men. French men love American women. Prices are too high. I haven't picked out my next husband yet. Might be the bartender. At least he has talent.
You've been interviewed before.
The last time, an hour ago. She wasn't very young or very attractive. The interview was very, very short. You can take your time.
A first trip to Paris?
No, no. First divorce here, that's all.
Why did you choose Paris?
I get saddle sores in Reno, and I lose too much money in Las Vegas.
According to our files, you were married four times.
Three. Annulments don't count. Leon?
Is something wrong?
Is something right? You really can't tell one of my marriages from another without a program. Husband number one, for love. Failure. Husband number two, for money. Failure, except for the money in the name Quarrel. Husband number three, an almond. He forgot to tell me he already had a wife. Husband number four, a bullfighter. Four times the bet. Haven't had a hit.
Any children involved?
No. And that's my only contribution to humanity. I told you I was a failure. Shouldn't you be writing this down?
Oh, the interview stopped long ago.
Thank you. I'm hungry. What about dinner?
I'm not on an expense account. I'm just a struggling newspaper man.
Well, stop struggling. The dinner is on my four husbands. I change and I'll be right down.
But what about
Please, Mr. Will. At home, my analyst charges $50 an hour to listen to me talk.
Hey, that's my taxi.
Charles. Oh, Claude, I'm glad to see you. How have you been?
Fine.
You look fine. How are you, Marion?
Fine.
You look fine. I'm fine, too. Oh, excuse me. My sister-in-law, Mrs. Mateen, Mr. Mateen, Mrs. Paul.
Hi.
Claude's with the prosecutor's office.
Oh? I hope we haven't done anything wrong.
Mrs. Quall just arrived in Paris. I'm interviewing her.
How's Helen?
Fine, fine. Oh, and you should see Vicky. She's... You know, we really should see more of each other. After all, family.
I'll get in touch with Helen in the morning.
Good night, Mrs. Quarles.
Good night.
Good night.
Good night.
Charles, I really would like to see you again. Good night.
Good night, Paul. Thank you.
I is, Hannon.
Now, what's one little wife among all your husbands?
I imagine you'll catch it when you get home.
From Helen? Not Helen. She's the most wonderful, most understanding. Do you mind if we don't go on with the interview? Somehow I'm suddenly cold sober. And it's awfully late, and if I don't get back to the office and do the story...
Can I go with you? To the office, I mean.
Why?
I don't know. Probably never see each other again, and I like to drag the night out a little. And I should see that story.
Well, that office is awful cold and dingy at this hour of the morning.
You'd be surprised how often I feel cold and dingy. I'll be simpatico.
Well, good morning. Now, what's the matter? Oh, Charlie, how could you? Don't Charlie me, sister. What about you? I'm sick and tired of you sitting around these crummy cafes day and night. The darling of every phony, petted by writers who don't write, adored by painters who don't paint. And what do you write? Interviews with useless, sloppy women. At least I don't jump into fountains and lap up all the liquor in Paris. Well, why don't you ask me why I drink, why I jump into fountains? That's right, blame me, blame me. Did I want to stay in Paris? What right have you to criticize me? You're suspicious. You? Ah, that's a laugh. Now you just listen to me.
Morning, darling.
Helen. Do you realize what time it is?
Does it matter, darling?
It's 8:00 in the morning.
It's your turn to take Vicky to school.
Do you realize I've been out all night?
Poor darling. All right, I'll take her to school.
Well, don't you care where I've been?
You look awful. Was it a tough assignment?
I was interviewing a woman.
Oh, that's nice. We're a much better copy than that.
She was a rich, beautiful, exciting woman. She was interested in me. Well, don't you even care?
What are you trying to say to her?
I'm trying to say that I love you.
What kind of a woman did you say she was?
How many kinds are there?
Was she really pretty?
I'd lie about it, but Marion saw it too.
Yes, she's very pretty.
Marion?
We ran into Claude and Marion. She'll probably try to build it up into something, but...
Just how rich and how pretty was she?
Oh, shut up. I don't hear a thing, do you?
I'll be back in a minute. Hello? Marion? What? What? Say that again.
It's a lie. You know how Marion is never like me.
Charlie, we're rich. We're rich.
didn't you tell us?
I am not old. I couldn't tell you last night because I was celebrating last night. I stopped by Marion's on my way home this morning and had breakfast with her and told her that.
How much are we worth? Marion said that you said that we're stinking rich.
Marion always editorial.